Hello, friends. Some regions in the world are suffering damage from invasive animals. They increase in numbers rapidly, destroying landscapes, crops, or even attacking cattle farms. So how can farmers deal with millions of these animals that are attacking their farms on a daily basis? Now let's see that in a video.
Wild horses have survived in harsh environments, from cold winters to warm streams. They have conquered vast stairways and high hills and mountains. Wild horses keep walking without stopping, with the purpose of finding a new source of life. However, they don't know that these adventures are affecting the ecosystem. Explorers more than 400 years ago, when they set foot on American territory, domesticated wild horses and used them to serve their useful lives. However, during times of economic uncertainty, they were set free because their owners could no longer care for them. As a result, wild horse populations increased far beyond the ecological balance of the American West. As a result, native wildlife and plants are forced to compete with invasive wild horse populations. This war has worsened the region's drought. In 1971, these horses were rounded up, causing their numbers to dwindle. However, wild horse advocates say that killing them is barbaric and have called for an end to the practice. They requested that wild horses be dealt with by bringing them into herd management areas. The fight for grazing land for wild horse advocates and farmers is far from over, but the reality is that livestock is running out of food before wild horses even set foot here. Cattle were previously free to enjoy the peaceful space. The grasslands you see now have passed through, and what they leave behind is a desolate wasteland. Farmers in New Mexico State said their grazing land and produce had been cleared, and wild horses had eaten all the hay they had stored for their livestock. In the western states of the United States, raising livestock is becoming more and more difficult. They and their herds had to travel long distances to find new pastures that had not been destroyed by wild horses. Wild horses are capable of hunting for resources and are surprisingly adaptable to their environment. This environment is amazing, which is why it's such a problem to put all the wildlife in one environment. Wild horses still have an advantage over other species that are wandering and needy. Large numbers of wild horses create water shortages for other animals and irrigation for neighboring farms. Grass and tree roots were uprooted from the soil, and it took two seasons for the grassland to regenerate. Not only are native species affected, but the natural landscape is also poisoned by the actions of wild horses. There is no easy solution to controlling wild horse populations. They are often present in large quantities and have a large impact on the environment. People in the U.S. have tried many methods, including injecting birth control pills directly into wild horses. This, although quite crude and time-consuming, does little harm to the wild horse population. In farmers' grazing areas, chasing is a good way to prevent them from taking away livestock feed and to control populations in a minimally invasive way. However, opinions on how to handle wild horses remain controversial. Some people want officials to handle them in breeding facilities, while others want horses to continue to roam freely. People in the United States really think that wild horses represent a good part of the past. Something that brings back a natural sense of the wild and free spirit. However, that doesn't mean they will leave. The U.S. Bureau of Land Management, or BLM, estimates that there are more than 82,000 horses and donkeys across 10 western states. More than three times the number of horses that the federal government considers sustainable for a healthy ecosystem. However, according to a 2022 report in the Journal of Wildlife Management, there are approximately 300,000 horses roaming freely across various jurisdictions. Nationwide, including on tribal lands, state agencies and experts have invested heavily in birth control measures for the wildlife. Birth control is a good solution to prevent the rapid increase of wild horse populations. However, birth control is not the only solution, and requires the coordination of many different measures to ensure balance in the ecosystem. Wild horses have gone through a journey from mythology to the obsession of farmers today. Their appearance and impact are a typical example of the complex situation that humans face when changing the natural environment. Maintaining the balance between the environment and people poses many challenges, and controlling wild horse populations is a comprehensive solution to protect the environment and the farmers.
Wild boar, coyote, and white-tailed deer have always been considered the most damaging animals for agriculture and farmers in the United States. However, few people know that in recent decades, millions of wild bird species have also caused significant damage to farmers in this country, especially grain farmers. According to the USDA's 2021 report, the wild birds that cause the most damage to agriculture in the United States include rock pigeons, sparrows, and red-winged blackbirds. Also, another invasive bird is the European starling. This is also considered a concern of many farmers in the country, These are red-winged blackbirds, a common bird found throughout North America, including the United States. According to the United States Fish and Wildlife Service, in a survey in 2021, the organization estimates that between 120 million and 190 million red-winged blackbirds live in the United States. The population of this bird in North America may be more than 630 million individuals. In the southern states of the United States, red-winged blackbirds usually begin nesting and breeding from early March to late April. Females usually lay 3 to 4 eggs in the time from incubation to maturity. Cities usually last about 23 days, depending on weather conditions and the source of food they can get. The red-winged blackbird is known as a territorial bird, especially during the breeding season. If humans get too close to their nest, they will attack and defend their nest. These birds can perceive it as a threat and react aggressively. They are very sensitive to any intrusion they sense in their nesting territory. Even raptors that appear in their nesting territory will be attacked by red-winged blackbirds. They will not hesitate to attack and repel intruders. Red-winged blackbirds are considered to be fully physiologically mature when they reach 12 to 15 months of age. At this stage, the average weight of this bird is about 0.2 pounds, which is 3 times smaller than a pigeon. Like millions of wild parrots in Australia, red-winged blackbirds usually pose no problem to American farmers if they don't congregate in large flocks. Many even having a hobby of providing free food fees to attract these red-winged blackbirds to their garden. During the fall and winter, red-winged blackbirds often congregate in large flocks that migrate together or form large flocks. It can also take place in places where these birds find an abundant food source. The flocks of red-winged blackbirds, which can number in the thousands or even tens of thousands of birds, often have the habit of feeding in wetlands or in grain fields. Red-winged blackbirds can eat seeds planted by farmers before they have a chance to germinate or grow. In addition, this bird also often appears in the fields of wheat, sunflower, or corn to feed before harvesting. If you are a sunflower or wheat farmer on a few acres, the presence of thousands of these birds in your field can cost your crop 30 to 50% of its yield. Not only does it affect agriculture, but the flocks of red-winged blackbirds also affect the tens of thousands that have appeared in urban areas, causing these areas to be horribly polluted. Due to the millions of piles of trash they leave behind. In recent years, the use of nets for crop protection or threat measures has been commonly used by farmers in some U.S. states to deal with red-winged blackbirds. When red-winged blackbirds congregate in groups, large herds, and migrate to agricultural areas. In addition to the red-winged blackbird, the European starling is also a concern for agriculture. In the late 1800s and early 1900s, they were introduced and inhabited here. Since then, the population of this European starling has increased rapidly, and they are considered one of the most successful birds in the United States. It is estimated that there are currently 250 million European starlings in North America. and about 75% of them live in the United States. European starlings often nest and breed in areas close to human habitation. They usually live in a pair, and each year a pair of European starlings usually give birth to 4 to 5 baby starlings. Like millions of European-style red-winged blackbirds, it doesn't matter if they don't gather in large flocks. Current states such as California, Texas, Florida, and Michigan are often home to the largest populations of European starlings in the United States. These are also the states that regularly record the appearance of European starling flocks of up to millions, such as red starlings. Large flocks of European starlings also have the habit of foraging in grain and vegetable fields. In addition to this invasive behavior, the European starling also regularly feeds on farms that grow fruit trees, such as cherries, grapes, and blackberries. The biggest problem faced by European starlings is sanitation, with large amounts of their droppings contaminating fodder or water in agricultural areas.
So since these solutions have been effective in preventing the growth of colonies of some invasive species, do you believe in any other better solution? If so, please don't forget to share your comments and opinions down below. Plus, don't forget to share, like, and subscribe to support our channel with our upcoming videos. And lastly, don't forget to share this video with all your friends so that they can watch it and enjoy it as well.